You see. Hi guys, you're watching channel Mr. Electron, and today in this video I'm going to teach you how to make a DC 12 volts soldering iron from a dead power transistor. This, what you see, is a 12 volts 55 watts car headlamp bulb, okay? 12 volts 55 watts H3, and these two are from a 12 volts adapter. Yeah, supply is on. Now this, what you see, is a pin from soldering iron tip. And guys, this what you see is a power transistor. Okay, you see MJE13009. It's a dead power transistor, not working. Okay, so let's check that first, if it is dead or not. So let's first check if it is dead or not. So guys, the easiest method to check a transistor if it is dead or it's working is by connecting the collector and emitter to the power supply and see if it's a closed circuit or not. So emitter means this one will be connected to the negative of the supply, done, and one terminal to the bulb and this terminal to the bulb. You see, it's lighting up. This indicates that even though I have not given any supply to the collector with the base, which is the basic for starting or powering or switching on the power transistor, it is still turning on, which means it's a short circuit. There is a little delay, but still it's a short circuit. You see, it's lighting up equally well with the base terminal. What about the collector and the base? Okay, it's again short, and base again short. So the power transistor is completely dead and short. So let's try and make a soldering iron with it. Now guys, after inserting the soldering iron tip in the hole of the power transistor, we have to find out the maximum resistance terminals. Okay, so let's check the resistance between this and this. It's 21 ohms. Now base and emitter, again 21, and collector and emitter, it is 0.6 ohms. So we have to go for the maximum. Either go for collector and base or base and emitter. Now let's cut off this unwanted terminal. And now I'm going to do the temperature check on this soldering iron. Okay, temperature. Yeah, done. Now the temperature should rise. See, it's rising rapidly. Well guys, there was a little change of plan. This was the initial soldering iron that I was making. You see, it was working, but I had to wait really long to get it heated up. So I decided, why not connect it directly? And you see, here you will see that I tested it before. I am going to show to you that the soldering occurred at the tip of the power transistor. So guys, the first part is to extend the wires with these 12 volts clips. Okay, let's keep this one aside. okay, and this one is base and this one is emitter. So yeah, this one is base. So base is positive and emitter is negative. So I will connect positive to the base. Done. Now emitter. Done. Yeah, and this is done. Red for positive and black for negative. Well guys, here as you can see that I have connected it to a 12 volt 7H UPS battery. Okay, and that's the wires. And that's my soldering iron. You see?
Hey, I forgot. If you are new to this channel, subscribe it now for